Shalom, shalom, yasha'ala, peace, Israel. First and foremost, I want to start off by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushua, Wahar, Rakakudash. Double honors to my apostles, elders, and great millstone, the men that taught me this truth through spirit. Peace and blessings to the elect of the house of Israel that is scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. Peace and blessings to you, few sisters listening and learning. Shalom to you as well. The name of this lesson is going to be a quick one. Who is in hell? Now, I really want to know, like, help a brother out. Who's in hell? The hell that you Christians and you different Israelite groups are talking about.
Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him.
As birds flying, so will the Lord of hosts defend Jerusalem. Defending also, he will deliver it, and passing over, he will preserve it.
For as the lightning cometh out of the east and shineth even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariot like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many.
Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, grace and mercy be known to the whole elect, scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, that are waiting on the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, my God. Today we're doing a response to a question that was done by GMS Rebuke the Temple on who is in hell. So basically what we're doing is we're kind of going back over a little bit of some of the stuff we talked about, but we're going to actually kind of be very specific with this, because what we notice is that whenever the discussion comes up for those that don't believe in eternal damnation, is that there's a lot of intellectual dishonesty. And among those is basically making the word hell and deciding to what you want it to be.
Right.
What you said in your video is talking about hell is you're talking about an actual condition. When you go into the Bible, in regards to what we're talking about a place of judgment.
Right.
Okay? When you go into the blue letter for the Old Testament, the New Testament, it tells you what context in which that word is being used. Because there's multiple words that are being used that are being substituted by the English word hell. And this is where you got to do a deeper dive study. So that's why we got to understand the way you worded your question, the way that you addressed it, you're being intellectually dishonest, and we know it.
Right.
Okay? So that's why we're responding to you, because we're going to make sure that the Lord, that it's marked, that you were told what it was, so you can't deny it in the day of judgment.
That's right. And what his question was, he asked, who is in hell?
Yeah, who is in hell?
You know what I'm saying? According to y'all doctrine, pretty much everybody in Israelite is in hell. You know what I'm saying? But according to Yahweh Shai, this is a future damnation for the unbelievers, man.
That's right.
And the unjust.
And we're basing it off your thumbnail, too, because you have the thumbnail with the pit of fire, which is basically the signification of hell, a fiery place of judgment. So you don't believe in that. We're going to show you how it's in the scriptures, and we're going to advise you to now do what you haven't been doing and your elders and GMS haven't been doing, which is going to the blue letter on this, starting in Matthew 23, which your brother going to bring.
And we want a response.
Yeah.
We want a response, man. This is the book of St. Matthew, chapter 23 and verse 29. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, because ye build the tombs of the prophets and garnish the sepulchres of the righteous, and say, if we had been in the days of our fathers, we would not have been partakers with them in the blood of the prophets. Wherefore ye be witnesses unto yourselves, that ye are the children of them which kill the prophets. Fill ye up then the measure of your fathers, ye serpents, ye generation of vipers. How can ye escape the damnation of hell?
Yeah, so when you go into that word in verse 33, for hell is Gehenna. We even had a younger brother, as we were talking to earlier, he pulled it up in the blue letter, and he saw that it said Gehenna, and he knew exactly what Gehenna was.
That's right, man.
He knew exactly, oh, that's the place where they dump the trash. Well, that's what the Most High is going to consider those that didn't believe.
Dump the trash.
They're going to
trash of Israel.
Yeah.
That's what he's going to use it for.
So it's a place where the wicked are going to be thrown. The ones that were not righteous, they're going to be in that place. And that's why Yahawashi was rebuking those wicked scribes and Pharisees because of the wickedness that they were doing. And they were also saying that they wouldn't have killed the prophets. And he told them, are those that killed the prophets. And he told them, how can ye escape the damnation of hell?
So now. It's a noun.
It's not an adjective. When you go into that word for Gehenna, it's a noun, which is a noun meaning a person, place, or a thing, which in this case, it's an actual place. Go and look up the word for hell in the New Testament. The other word is also Hades, which is similar to Sheol. It even tells you in there, man, y'all being intellectually dishonest. Your man's heart tries to use Hades to talk about the under this Greek mythology and all that stuff. Keep playing with that because you don't understand the Most High. Y'all are the ones that are teaching the scriptures. Now, if you're doing this out of ignorance, then repent, and you're going to have to leave them, guys. But we know you ain't. So we're just doing this just so it's known and on record that you was addressed on your questions.
Right.
Okay? Because that's what we're supposed to do, is address you. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go into Matthew 25, and Yahweh is going to talk about it to you. All
right.
So Matthew 25 and verse 41, then shall he say unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, unto everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was in hunger, and ye gave me no meat. I was thirsty, and ye gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and ye took me not in. Naked, and ye clothed me not. Sick, and in prison, and ye visited me not. Then shall they say, answer unto him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee in hunger, or thirst, or stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister unto thee? Then shall he answer them, saying, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not unto the least of these, ye did it not to me. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. So we didn't go into the whole chapter of Matthew 25, but you go back and you read about the separation of the sheep and the goats.
Right, man.
That's why Yahawashi was telling them, I have sheep that are not yet of this fold, then they shall come to me. So he had an elect that was among Israel that was going to be in his fold, and those that did not make it in his fold, they were going to be rejected. That's why it's not called the lost goats of Israel, it's the lost sheep of Israel.
Uh-huh.
But remember, the sheep of Israel versus the goat of Israel, it's a difference.
That's right, bro.
Okay?
It's a difference.
Just like he separates the sheep from the goats, he's going to separate the wicked Israelites from the righteous Israelites in that day.
Right.
Go ahead.
Like we were talking about earlier, about Matthew 5 and 17.
Yeah.
About the least in the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah.
You know?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, that's a clear separation. Yeah, we're going to get into it later and show you that separation.
Yeah.
But it's a separation, man. You're going to have to on the left hand and on the right hand side, man. Right. You're gonna have eternal life, then you're gonna have eternal damnation.
That's why he had to, he said, these will go to everlasting punishment, these are eternal life.
That's the balance of the Most High.
Exactly. Everybody being having eternal life doesn't make any sense.
Right.
It's not even biblically sound what y'all pushing, and you're deceiving not only yourself, but those that are listening to you. So that's why we have to warn you. We don't care about what y'all think about us, because at the end of the day, the word's going to be true and stand firm regardless. The only thing you can do is don't try and omit it or deny, just like y'all don't want to go into Gehenna in Matthew 23 and 33. Y'all refuse to do that because y'all want to seem and have an advantage over the understanding of the subject, and y'all don't.
Right.
Unfortunately for y'all, y'all don't.
And that eternal means eternal, man.
Yeah, it means forever.
And the everlasting fire means everlasting, bro.
Right.
Forever.
Where the worm dies not and the fire is not quenched.
That's right, man. That means forever.
And it means not quenched, meaning it's never put out.
That don't mean just a long, long, long time, and then it's no more. Now, that means forever, bro.
Yeah.
You're going to get a precept to that scripture. That Matthew 25. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 21 and verse 7. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the filfer and unbelieving and the abominable and the murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake with burning with fire and brimstone, which is the second death.
Come on.
The lake and the fire and the burning the brimstone, which is the second death, man. This ain't talking about no missiles, man. This is talking about hell, eternal damnation, man, for all the wicked. It just named the wicked above that. And just like we just brought out Matthew 25, it said that those who shall endure till the end gonna get the eternal life, man. And then in the second verse, it tell you all the wicked gonna get eternal damnation, which is the second death, man.
Right.
It says Satan and his angels shall be cast into the lake of fire, man. Then so if the lake of fire is the missiles, then how in the hell is Satan? Satan gonna get hit by the missiles?
They're gonna probably say it's Esau, because a lot of times, y'all interchange Satan with the spiritual demon Satan and with Esau. So that's, I think, part of the confusion in y'all's doctrine, too.
Right.
You know? Esau is the devil. No, Satan is the devil.
But who is Satan angels, though? Who is his angel?
Come on.
But that's two different, Satan and his angels.
That's right. And that's when you get to Revelation 21, Babylon's already destroyed by then.
It's out of there.
This is the judgment. This is the judgment day for those that were going to be found written in the book of life.
12.
So if you're not found written in the book of life, you were cast into the lake of fire. In fact, did you keep reading on? Who was all cast in there? The sorcerers and the whoremongers?
That's what I just read before that. Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I read before.
Yeah.
That.
All the people, the sorcerers, the whoremongers, the idolaters, the fornicators, all that stuff. All those people didn't make it, and they were cast there. That's why we preach repentance.
Yeah.
Repentance, baptism, repentance of the remission of sins.
Yeah.
You got to get your sins remitted, and you got to live according to righteousness in Yahweh Shai.
That's right, man.
You know what I'm saying? So the brother brought out a precept. There, I'm going to bring out. You got to do more of that?
No.
Isaiah 66, we started verse 22. Mm-hmm. So this is when the kingdom of heaven is already set up. So if you want to know who is in hell, who is going to be in this hell that we're talking about, it's going to stand right here. For as the new heavens and the new earth, which I will make, shall remain before thee, saith Yahweh, so shall your seed and your name remain. Talking about the elect. Their seed and their name is going to remain because they're in the book of life.
Right, man.
Verse 23, and it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, saith Yahweh. And they shall go forth and look upon the carcasses of the men that had transgressed against me. For their worm shall not die, neither shall their fire be quenched, and they shall be an abhorring to all flesh.
That's the same thing Yahweh Shah said.
Come on.
The same words Yahweh Shah said.
And if you go into the, if you go into your concordance, if you got a Bible with a concordance, it's going to reference you to red letter with Yahweh Shah.
That's right, man. That's right. So hell is a place, man.
Yeah.
It is literally a place where the wicked going to be at forever.
That's the least in the kingdom.
That's the least in the kingdom in Matthew 5:17.
Yeah, every side of the new moon, the that's righteous... Right. That was given eternal life in Matthew 25 are going to observe the torture of the wicked that was sent to everlasting punishment and damnation.
That's right, bro.
So that's where who is in hell, Gehenna, that is.
Yep.
So y'all going to play with that grave. Hell is the grave. It's going to be everything else but Gehenna that we're talking about now.
Yep.
We know that there's the grave, there's the abodement of the souls, which is Sheol, and then you have Gehenna, bro. But y'all don't want to go into that, and it's unfortunate that we have to address it, but we're going to keep addressing it, because we had to tell some young, we had to talk to some younger brothers, and they saw it too. We just saw it earlier today.
Yep.
And it just so happened they were talking about the same subject before they rolled up. You know what I'm saying? So, you got anything else with that?
Yeah,
one after death. Yeah, better yet. Second death. So the brother gonna go into what is the second death referring to? Because, like we said earlier, before in past lessons, the wicked Israelites are not coming back as babies. In these last days, those will be resurrected from the dead. The ones that died, whether they were wicked or righteous, will be resurrected from the dead for the day of judgment.
Yep.
In front of the throne. That's already talked about.
Right, man.
That's why Yahweh says to the apostles that you 12 will be sitting on 12 thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Because there's going to be a judgment day. That's referring to what? Matthew 25. So the brother going to go into it.
Second Andrews. Chapter 9 and verse 9. Then shall they be in a pitiful case, which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torment.
Shall dwell in torments.
For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed my law, will they have yet while they have yet had liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, which is now, understood not, but despised it.
Yeah, understood not, like we talk about baptism. A place of repentance is a time for you to get right, but then there's an order in which we talk about how it has to be done. There's a straight gate that you got to enter into for repentance.
Right.
Which Yahweh Shah showed. Okay, keep going.
Verse 12. The same must know it after death by pain. Now that's heavy, man.
Yep.
That's heavy.
You're going to know it after death by pain. Which is that second death.
That second death, man.
Because they got to die.
In torment. They're going to be in torment, man. Ain't that something? Ain't that go right along with Lazarus and the rich man?
Yep. Because death is an actual power in and of itself. It's actually a force. It's actually an energy force that the Most High created. That's why death is something that people don't want to experience.
Yep.
Like, what did Paul talk about? The sting, death, where is thy sting?
Uh-huh.
The sting is going to be the torment.
The torments, man. That's going to be that sting, bro.
Yeah, the torment. That's the second death. They're not experiencing life, but an eternal feeling of death, which is the torment.
That's what
sting of death.
That's what Isaiah was speaking of in Isaiah 6:6, yep. Which is just right.
Yep, the continual sting of death.
Yep.
That's the second death.
Yep.
Because it's a continual sting of death. The torment.
Yep.
Dwelling in torment. The carcasses, but the worm don't die and the fire's not quenched.
Fire's not quenched, man.
So when people die, they decay and the worms take over their body.
And that's torture.
Yeah.
You're going to keep reliving that stuff every day, bro. That's torture.
I know it's hard to believe, but the Most High is able to keep somebody in a continual state of torture.
That's right.
With worms and fire.
He going to have the other people in a continual state of eternal life.
Right.
With no death.
Right.
So he can do just the opposite, man.
Yeah, the Most High got that. he's got that much beef.
That's right.
With a lot of our people.
That's right. Whether you believe it or not.
He got beef with the people on that level. People that were sacrificing their kids to Molech. People that was killing and murdering the innocent.
Yeah, they was killing the prophets, man.
Yeah, they was killing the prophets.
Those are the ones that's going to be in the pit of hell, man.
Yep.
Eternal judgment.
Yeah, and them wicked scribes and Pharisees.
That's what he was prophesying then.
Yep.
Yahweh Shai was prophesying that, man.
Yep.
Telling them that they wasn't going, he knew they wasn't going to repent.
He said they wasn't going to escape it.
Yeah.
They were going to escape the damnation, meaning there's no way out. You could think that when you die and you're going to come back as a baby, the Most High is like, no, I'm going to resurrect you from the dead. I'm going to bring you before the throne. I'm going to show you you're not in the book of life. And then I'm going to have the angels cast you into the lake of fire.
And if those lake of fire said miss or something, but what happened to the Israelites on the other side of the world?
Come on.
What happened? What's going to happen to them?
All them wicked northern kingdom and Israelites south of the border chopping up whole families.
Right. What's going to happen to them?
There's no escape. That's what y'all should say. You ain't going to escape it.
No, sir.
It's going to go and go to Damona, Israel. You're not going to go to Costa Rica, go to Thailand, the Philippines, go live in Colombia, Costa Rica, Panama.
Yep.
He's like, you ain't going to escape it. No matter where you go, you're going to escape. And that's what pains a lot of you guys that are against this truth about this eternal judgment. You know you ain't right, and you don't want that judgment. So if you fear the Lord, and you fear him that not only can kill the body, but can't do nothing to it, fear him that can destroy what? Both your soul and body in hell. So with that, we're going to give all glory and praise to
Yahweh Shai.
Grace and mercy be bound to the hopeful next, scattered throughout the four corners of the earth.
Shalom.